Hi, I'm Joe, and I'm here to help you square up a vise today. So first thing is to make sure your work holding equipment is clean. You want to make sure there's no chips stuck on the bottom side. It's the same thing on your table. Make sure it's nice and clean and also dry. So once you've made sure it's clean, it's also always good at practice to use a honing stone. You can often get these from a local sharpening stone distributor as well. The whole point is to take off any raised burrs from, say, dropping a tool or dropping the vise. It's always good to hone the full surface, even if you're just putting it in one spot. You want to do it both to the table and to the vise. So no high spots, should be good to go. So now that everything's cleaned and honed, being careful to lift with your knees and not your back. Flip over the vise. Don't pinch your fingers. And I always like to slide it around because that'll give me a good indication if I'm sitting on any chips. It should have a bit of resistance because you have the full surface trying to move across each other. So now I'll grab my T-nuts. T-nuts or angle clamps, doesn't matter what. You just need something to hold the vise down. Snug these up by hand till they're about tight. And then I'll just kind of eyeball machine the vise square. You also want to be careful how far the vise sticks out the back. Because if you have it too far, you can risk running into your column on the back side. Mount your magnetic indicator base. The important thing is to make sure that this is square or perpendicular to the face of the vise we want to measure. If you're off at all, you get a cosine effect. And if you remember math from high school, that's great. If you don't, you know to avoid it. So make sure you have everything nice and square. We're trying to make sure that our machine axis is square to our vise so that when we take a workpiece and flip it over, it's going to repeat and all the sides are going to line up. Otherwise, if your vise is a little bit off, you'll see that angle on your part. I'm going to bring this now until it contacts. There we go. Okay, I just want it to barely read. So I just want to get it to the point where I'm just reading on the dial a little bit. Both ways and X, and as you can see, we got a bit to go. This side is a little bit closer to us because it's pushing on the dial more. If I go the other way, now it's not touching at all. So, pro tip, tighten one side and treat it as a pivot point. I'm going to do this side because it's already touching. I know where it's at. So, gonna snug this down a fair amount. And this one I just wanna be a little bit to finger tight, a little bit past finger tight. But this one I wanna have a significant amount more pressure on. What this does is pivots around this point. So, I'm basically gonna start moving my dial back and forth and watching as it only, as it doesn't move from zero. So it's going to move a lot until I bring it in, and then it'll read zero. So now it's just a matter of going back and forth and X a whole bunch. So I was at, so I'm starting at revolution round about 7. So I'll just keep that number in my head. And now I'm just going to start tapping the vise with my dead blow hammer. Until I start to see a similar number. Yep. It's about the same region. See, I'm close, but no cigar. So now I'm at about 2 or 3. And then I'm at about 7, so that's 5 difference. I could be fighting this all day, so I think I'm actually just going to take it right to zero. Just tap it in. You can see it actually starts moving farther away, so it went a little bit too far. So back it off a little bit. It may seem like you're going back and forth a little bit, like I just did there, but that's part of the game. We're all human, kind of get used to it. The idea is to get it so that needle doesn't move at all. I'm going to tighten this down a little bit more so my hits don't have as much impact. So I'm going to tighten this one to about the tightness of this side. I'm going to tighten this one more so it's still my pivot point. All right. And even after you tighten the nuts, you will see a difference in where it's sitting. All right, so let's go to 3.
You always want to indicate the non-moving jaw of the vise for the best precision.
Now I'm going to move it just a little bit in Y, so it's right up and down. Is when I'm looking at the dial right now, I'm looking straight on. If you look at it from the side, you can kind of change what number you see. If we had the indicator horizontal, we would basically be looking down on the needle and you'd lose a couple thousandths, which in this line of work is important. Got just a hair more to go. That's it. So as you saw, we're pretty much there. I could spend some time and get the last little tenths out, but then I'm using the wrong tools. This is only a 5/10 indicator. If I want to get closer, I'll get a 1/10 indicator and I could get this thing perfect. But in the end, I'm going beyond the accuracy of the machine and it's really only satisfying my OCD to do anything more. So at this point, I just want to make sure everything's nice and tight. That one could have gone a little bit farther. This one's already at good tightness. I'll do one last rip around. No significant movement, so my tightening didn't move it at all. This vise is now square. So why did I spend all this time when I could have used keys and all that other fun stuff that come with some vices? Well, this gets me right on. Right now from this dial indicator, I can tell I'm within 5/10. When you use keys, there's gap, so you can actually fit them down into the slots of the table, and your table might not be ground perfectly, or the keys might not be the same width, so you're always going to have a little bit of play, way more than if you actually get an indicator on it. So you always want to indicate a vise in for the best precision. Squaring isn't only for vises. It's also good practice to use on your fourth axis and also your wrap turns to make sure that everything is in line with the machine axis. Thank you for watching. Check out our latest YouTube videos here. And for more metalworking hootenanny, subscribe to our YouTube channel.